both Edward Leedskalnin and Tesla believe that atomic force that we consider to be caused by collections of particles in the internal analog of the atom to actually be caused by an external connection that is always there, which sounds a bit eerie in that it sounds very similar to quantum entanglement and quantum physics. And the great thing about it is that Tesla and Leedskalnin did believe that voltage was speed. I think that a much better description of voltage is pressure. If we look at the chemical components that actually produce the spark, it's just a hammer. It's just the atoms themselves and the way that they're arranged to each other. It's something that I've been researching for a very long time. I spent 2 decades of my life looking at free energy, the occult, new science, new age science, quantum physics, and what I found was the best way to explain the things I can see, if they really are there, is to understand exactly how the traditional classic physics works and look at what exactly is different between Tesla's physics and Einstein's physics, Edward Leedskalnin's physics, and, you know, Isaac Newton's physics, and so on and so forth. There's really a lot of information that I would like to share, and it seems very strange that a man that is gentle, apparently soft, apparently not well educated, but driven enough to build an extraordinary building, an unusual achievement, an accomplishment in itself, but to in fact write books about electrical theory and politics and other strange things, and to create newspaper articles separate to that saying, describing indeed a new model for gravity, and indeed it connects with the way in which the electric magnet transformer that he has, because it's shorted transformer, it actually can be charged up, so it has a very dense field. It seems to me like the man is trying to create a black hole, because obviously we know that the star, when it collapses and becomes into a small mass, it has much higher gravitation. It can bend light. I've noticed the transformer can also bend light, and they're used in the accelerators that the science men have. I forget where I was. It's just the zone. Yeah, so I mean, if we are to assume that uranium is only dangerous because of an external cause, it's only highly reactive with other matter, because of the fact that there's an external cause jumbling around all of its particles, hitting each other, because our classical science just believes that they're jumbling around, hitting each other. But Tesla and Leedskalnin introduced this idea that it's being caused by the other planets and the other stars. And when you look at something like the ocean, you start to understand that something is going on, and it must be. But the only reason why it goes on in the ocean is because of its length. Because the ocean extends over such a vast landscape that it actually is not on level ground. It's curved. So it means if there is a pull, even a gentle pull of the moon, it's not that hard, it will cause all of the water to move there, and of course, it's a lot easier